9 tips on how to wake up early and actually be a morning person. So I am actually a very morning person. I wake up at 5 in the morning pretty much every single day of the week, give or take one day, because I have to teach at 5:40 in the morning. So I'm up and ready to go by 5 in the morning. And you guys genuinely really liked my 5 a.m. morning routine, so I thought I would share with you guys some tips and ways in which you can wake up a little bit earlier to give yourself a more productive and mindful day. I've always been a morning person. I love the mornings, but the reason I like the mornings is because you wake up and it's super bright and sunny out. And when I wake up now at 5 in the morning, it's still dark, which took me a while to kind of get used to. Because it was dark, I was just in that mindset of I need to be sleeping right now. I wasn't much of a morning person as if I was like waking up with the sun all bright and sunny. These 9 tips definitely helped me change that around and actually enjoy waking up at 5 in the morning every single day. So I'm going to be going through things that you can do the night before, things you could do when you actually have to wake up, as well as the morning of. So the first tip that I have for you guys is to do a 10 to 15 minute cleanup the night before. So the night before is really important to ensure that you're having a good morning, because you're kind of setting up being able to wake up in a happier mindset. So doing a 10 to 15 minute clean will ensure that your environment is nice and clean and all decluttered, so that when you're waking up, you don't wake up to a cluttered mess and just want to crawl back into your bed. I always say this, but cleaning is something that honestly is so therapeutic to me. And when I clean and there's no clutter in my house, it almost mindfully declutters me as well. And you feel more inspired to wake up because everything is in its place. You don't feel like that kind of grogginess that like clutter brings you. And it's just really, really important in order to have the motivation to actually wake up. Because you've had such a motivated night, you're more easily to flow into more of a motivated morning. So something else that you can do the night before is to set your goals or set up, plan your day the night before. So this is really, really important because not only have you cleaned your environment and decluttered that, but you're also mindfully decluttering. We have so many different thoughts and so many different emotions and things that we want to accomplish the day before. When you wake up with all that clutter in your mind, again, it's so much easier to just huddle back into your bed and go to bed and not wake up because you don't want to deal with it right now, because we're just in that really tired, groggy mindset when we wake up. So when you sit there and plan out your day, not only do you have something to look forward to, but you've already decluttered your mind. So you're waking up with a clean environment, you're waking up with a clean mind, and you are ready to start the day because you're more inspired and you have your day already planned and you're ready to just tackle the day. So when it comes to actually waking up, the third tip that I have for you guys is to set your alarm away from you. Like actually having to get up to set off your alarm, not only will you hit snooze less, but you are already up and awake. You are more likely to stay up and awake. When you set your alarm and you're sleeping and your phone is right there and your alarm goes off, it's so easy to just turn that off and turn back around because you're already sleeping. You've had literally 1 second to wake up to turn off your alarm. So you're still in that, like, again, groggy, tired mindset. Whereas if you set your alarm farther away from your bed and you have to actually get up to go turn it off, you have jolted your mind because you're standing up, you've walked around a little bit, so you're more awake and have had time to wake up more than just having your alarm like right next to you. So the fourth tip that I have for you guys is to get rid of your mental sabotage. When you wake up, the first thought you have is, oh my gosh, it's so dark out. Oh my gosh, I can't believe I'm waking up this early. This sucks. Like all this negativity, and it's just reasons and excuses that you give yourself to give you a reason of why you shouldn't be up at this time. Whereas instead of just sitting there mentally sabotaging yourself, why don't you enjoy the process and build yourself up? Like, I can't believe I just woke up this early. This is amazing. I can start my day before everyone else is, and this is so productive and I feel so happy. Like, give yourself more positive verbiage in the morning. When you wake up early, a lot of the times you sit there and literally bitch about it, and that's not gonna make it fun or enjoyable for anyone. When you wake up, make sure that you're saying positive things to yourself. If you do say something negative, catch it and switch it over to positive. For example, instead of saying, I have to wake up early, say, I get to wake up early. This is really nice. This is definitely a luxury. So the fifth tip that I have for you guys is to set your atmosphere. So you have a decluttered little space. You've kind of cleared out your mind. You're ready to start the day. You're up and ready to go. But then you look around and everything is just like so dark and eerie. You know, turn on some lights, put some twinkle lights on, light a candle, put on some nice cozy coffee house music. I personally like to close my blinds because I do wake up before the sun is up. So when I close my blinds, it like makes me feel like it's morning time because I'm not seeing the darkness and I put my lights on. So it just ensures that I'm more of like awake and it less likely to get in that mental sabotage of telling myself it's not even sunny out, why am I awake? So it's really important that you're setting your environment up to be more happy and motivated. Establishing a good environment can definitely play a role in getting you up and being more happy and positive about it. So the sixth tip that I have for you guys is to chug back a glass of water. So I know a lot of the times people say that coffee is what wakes them up, but to me, chugging back a glass of water after like an 8 hour night's worth of sleep really just jolts me up. I don't know what it is. I drink cold water in the morning. I know some people drink like lukewarm water with like lemon, but I'm not that fancy. I literally just drink a nice cold glass of water. And I don't know if it's metabolism and that's why, but I think personally it's because when we're sleeping, we get a little bit dehydrated. And when you're dehydrated, your mind can get a little bit foggy and tired. So when I drink water, I'm like rehydrating myself and my brain is more functionally performing at its peak. So the seventh tip that I have for you guys is to accomplish something within the first hour of waking up. If you wake up and you know, watch TV and stuff, that's not that bad. But when you accomplish something, it will guarantee a more productive morning and mindset. For example, I like to work in the morning. I'll, you know, go through my emails before anyone has had the time to wake up and I can just like knock all the emails out that I got the day before. Or, you know, I work for Q Kids, so I'll teach a few courses. I really like working out in the morning. When I work out in the morning, it makes me feel really happy and my endorphins are running and it just gets me motivated and I can check something off my to-do list. You can go somewhere. You know, go pick up a breakfast for yourself. Go take a little walk with your dog. It can be as simple as making your bed in the morning. Like just doing something that, again, kind of checks off your to-do list just guarantees a more productive morning because it's easier to flow that accomplishment throughout the day because you've already accomplished something, so you're starting it. And then it's just more easily to flow throughout your day because it's kind of gets you pumped and like wanting to accomplish more. Whereas like if you just sit there and do nothing or just kind of like lazy around your house, you're more likely to sit there and lazy around your house and again, think of things of why you shouldn't sit there and do the things that you said that you were going to do and just self-sabotage yourself again. So the eighth thing that I have is to have the intention of being productive. This kind of flows with the last tip that I had and just doing something to ensure productivity. You don't want to start your day being lazy. You want to start your day being productive. That way, again, it will flow throughout your day. So don't wake up and immediately go on social media because that can, again, create negative emotions. You can become a little bit lazy, put things off, get kind of wrapped into that mindset of just clicking and clicking and clicking until like an hour's passed and you're still on social media and you just woke up for no reason, or like watching TV and just not accomplish the things that you were set to accomplish. And just starting your day off like that to me is just like, ugh, I really don't like doing that. So instead of doing social media or watching TV or doing mindless tasks, try, you know, listening to a podcast or getting up and showering and getting ready, going to like work out, read a book. It'll make you feel good and productive and get you in a happy mindset rather than feeling like a zombie in the morning. So the ninth thing is more of a reminder than an actual tip. And that's just to remember that the more that you do it, the easier it becomes. It's like practice makes perfect. The more that you wake up earlier, and the more you accomplish, the more you put it into your routine. Like when I first started waking up at 5 a.m, I did it because I had class, so I had to do it, and I had to wake up every single day at 5 a.m. And because I just instantly started waking up at 5 a.m, I got into that mindset of that's just my routine. Like I had to do it. So that was just part of my routine. So now when I'm like sleeping in on the weekends, I don't tend to sleep in until like 8 o'clock. I tend to sleep until like 7 o'clock, maybe 6:30, you know, and I kind of crave that habit of waking up early because it's already been established into my routine. So it might be a little bit hard at first, but don't beat yourself up over that and give yourself a break. Like if you don't want to wake up at 5 in the morning every single day, or if you want to wake up at 8 o'clock, if 8 o'clock is your early morning, you know, by all means, it's all up to you. But when you want to accomplish a goal, don't think that you're going to do it once and it's going to be so simple. Like, the more you do it, the more it becomes part of your habit and your daily routine, and the easier it will become. So just keep it going. If you have a goal for yourself, you know, do it. And the more you do it, the easier it is. So that is it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys all in a future video. Bye, guys.